Well, in continuation of the corporate finance, for my students, I am again here to discuss something about very peculiar, very specific regarding the capital structure of the firm. Capital structure comprises of your equity and a part of your debt-based instruments, debentures and bonds. And also if a company raises funds from the banks, so that will be also be the part of the capital structure. Here in this session, I will be specific to the part of debentures. Later part, I will be discussing the hairline differences between the bonds and the debentures. But here, couple of weeks back, Tata Housing Finance Corporation issued debentures rupees 500 crores in the market, and that debentures were NCDs basically. So non-convertible debentures, and partially amount was specifically for those investors who prefer the CDs, the convertible debentures. So here we will just quickly take a look what is the meaning of that the debentures. So we will here write the debentures. In the debentures we have the convertible debentures and non-convertible debentures. Unlike bonds, perpetual bonds and the zero coupon bond and the coupon rate and perpetual and a lot of, you know, the specification in the bonds. But in debentures, basically we need to know the convertible debentures and the non-convertible debentures. So here, I'm writing here convertible debentures. And here I am going to write, or preferably I will not write, just will be able to understand this, NCDs, non-convertible debentures. From the name it is very clear that if the debenture is non-convertible, that means is at any cost till redemption rate or redemption dates are applied on that, these will not be converted into the shares. But if the debentures are converted in the form of the convertible debentures, so that will be further divide into two parts, the partially convertible or fully convertible debentures, okay. And if whether it is a partially convertible debenture or the fully convertible debenture, okay, there are certain components which an analyst or researcher or academician or the stock analyst, they need to understand what are the components required to calculate the intrinsic value of the debentures and to for the comparative study regarding with the NCDs or the bonds or equity-based instruments in the market. If we talk about the whether it is a partially or fully, but the point wise I will be discussing that it always have the face value. For an example, if it is somewhere 1000, okay, then 1000 at the rate of, because it is also here it is need to specify. For an example, if I say at the rate of 9%, so what does it mean? It means if the face value of one debenture is 1000, then 9% rate of interest will be applied on that. That means 90 rupees per debenture. Second part, after a certain period of time, there must be some market price of the value, okay, market price of the debenture that goes, for an example, it comes to now 950 rupees. And as an investor, you have found the intrinsic value of the debenture in the market. Maybe it is already given in the question, or maybe you have calculated by doing the discounting at the rate of your expected rate of return. For example, you think that at the 9% per annum is not required, and 12% is your expected rate of return. So on the basis of your expected rate of return, you calculate the intrinsic value. So that is known as the intrinsic value of the debenture. Somewhere, if you go through the notes of the chartered accountancy or the cost accountancy, you will find that most of the time it is given as a straight value, sometimes intrinsic value, sometimes a straight value. So for an example, if it is coming here 750 rupees, okay, and I'm also writing here in this sign that straight value, if it is given like this, so don't get confused because it is more or less same. And after that, as I have said, this is a partially or fully convertible debenture because it is a further extension of the Tata Capital Housing. Because and I am taking just an example, if you go through the moneycontrol.com or a BSE India, you will find the exact figures published by the Tata Capital Housing Finance. So I am just giving this precise example to make you guys understand that how does the value of the debentures calculated, right? So and how is this analyzed? So intrinsic value is coming here 750, which is also known as the straight value. After that, if it is given for an example conversion rate, that is very very important. Conversion rate, most of the time students, they do not understand what is the meaning of that conversion rate, and it is given for an example here 30. So what does it mean here? That means for each debenture, the Tata Housing Finance or any other company which is issuing the debentures or has issued the debentures, they will give 30 shares in exchange of the one debenture. Okay, so that is the meaning of the conversion rate. And if the conversion rate is given, obviously they will give you some expected dividend. So I am writing here expected DIV, expected dividend. For an example, it is coming 1 point, or just in a round figure, if you take a look here, so that will be easier to understand. Expected dividend is rupees 2. If the expected dividend is rupees 2 and the ongoing market price of the share is, for an example, if I say just it is somewhere right here 40 rupees, okay. So if you convert your entire debentures in the market, so you will get 30 shares, right? You will get what? 30 shares in an exchange of the value. 30 shares. And the market price of the share is 40, okay? And the straight away, you are getting 90 rupees per annum dividend. And the current market price of the debenture, which is listed on the stock exchanges, 950. You have calculated the intrinsic value that is coming here 750. So obviously it is crystal clear that if the intrinsic value is coming down, okay, is coming down from your expected rate of return, so that means this will be considered as overpriced. So what will be the decision? For the decision making point of view, it is easier to decide whether to convert your shares in the debentures, to convert your debentures into share will be feasible idea, or to retain or to get the redemption value in the last after getting 90 rupees per annum straight away your interest. But here, if I just give you some more examples here, or in the second way, for an example, you have 50 debentures, okay. So if you have, for an example, I say 50 shares, 50 debentures, you have what? 50 debentures, and on one debenture you are getting 30 shares, okay. So on 50 debentures you will get how much? So just apply the law of parity here. So on 50 debentures, you will get 1500 shares of the company, okay, of the company. Now just take a look, if you deal with this 15 shares, if you are getting 15 shares of an exchange of the 50 debentures, okay, so and expected dividend per share is rupees 2, okay, so 1500 debenture multiplied by 2, that means you are getting what? You are getting 3000 as a part of interim dividend declared by the company. So it is expected dividend, but I am just making an assumption that you will be given this much of the dividend. So 3000 rupees you are getting on conversion of your debentures into the shares. After that, 1500 shares, the market price is 40 rupees. So what will be the total value? Okay, so after converting 1500 shares at the rate of, I just write here like this, 1500 shares, okay, 1500 shares at the rate of 40 rupees, at the rate of 40 rupees. So you are getting here, just calculate here, 15 for the 60, so that means you are getting about 60,000. If you convert those debentures in the shares and sell in the market, so you will get 60,000 plus 3,000 this, okay, 3,000. So in totality you are about to get 63,000 rupees, okay, 63,000 rupees you are getting. So if you can directly compare whether it will be feasible to convert the entire debentures into the share, okay, you will compare to the your the face value of the debentures and then the market current market price of the debenture, and here you are getting 9% per annum interest rate. So it is very easy to compare whether if it is found feasible to convert all the debentures into the shares of the company or partially exchanged value of the debentures into the shares. So this is up to an investor, but here in my case it is coming, or it looks feasible, if you convert your entire debentures, the 50 debentures you will convert into the shares, and you will get 1500 shares at the rate of 40. If you sell in the market, you will get 60,000 rupees, and the dividend declared here is expected dividend is for an example rupees 2, so you will get this much of the dividend, and then it is a feasible investment.